Hey guys, Michael Stroud here with your Richmond Wellness Team. Today I wanted to go over some tips that can make your workout experience a little more beneficial. So one mistake I see a lot of people making, always start with your biggest muscle groups first, okay? By this I mean, if you're gonna go in and do, we'll say an upper body day, you're not gonna go in and do curls and then expect to do your pull-ups, pull-downs, all that, because your biceps are already fatigued and they're going to, in this smaller muscle group, so your back's actually going to come up short, okay? So same thing with people go in, the first thing they want to do is, they're going to hit some triceps, they're going to do some press downs, and then they're going to try to go do some chest press. Smaller muscle group compared to the chest, so this little muscle here is going to fatigue a lot faster than your big pecs, and you're not going to get as much from that pressing motion. Same standpoint, if you're going to do, let's say you're doing giant sets or supersets, don't superset a lat pull down and a bicep curl, okay? It's going to work great for one set. After that one set, your biceps are going to smoke. You're going to go back to your lat pull down, and your back is not getting the workout it needs to get. Your biceps are going to get a great workout, but not your bigger muscle groups. So stick with compound movements first, okay? When I say compound movements, I mean multi-joint movements. Your pull-downs, your presses, things that are having to get a few muscle groups involved before you start moving on to, you know, dumbbell lateral raises, curls, press downs. So with that said, also, I see this common mistake a lot. A lot of guys out here doing this one. Don't go in and do an arm day, okay? You're wasting your time. If you don't go, you're not going to go in there and spend 45 minutes to an hour on a small muscle groups like bicep, tricep. You're going to get a lot more bang for your buck. Go in and do a chest and back day, okay? So now we're working the big muscle groups, and do a little burnout exercise at the end for your biceps and triceps. Knock yourself out. Have fun with it. But it's a small muscle group. You do not need that much volume for it. Okay. So again, I know a lot of people out there, they like to go in and they want to hit three or four different exercises for their bicep, three sets each. Okay. And the same for the tricep. You don't need that. If I'm doing a pull up or a pull down, I'm doing elbow flexion. I'm hitting my biceps, right? If I'm doing a row, elbow flexion, I'm hitting my biceps. If I'm doing a chest press, okay, elbow extension, I'm working my tricep. You see the point? So I'm able to actually push and pull a lot more weight by doing these bigger movements. So my arms are getting the work. And then at the end of the workout, if I feel like I want a little more, I'll do, you know, dumbbell bicep curls for a burnout set or something like that, okay? If any more gym tips or anything, feel free to reach out, drop a comment. Email is mstroud, STROUD, @partnermd.com. Thanks, guys.